Hello, everybody, and welcome to another Aha Moment. I am very excited today to be with Tara Robertson. For those of you who don't know me, I am Christina Brady. I am the president of Sales Assembly, and we have partnered with Sales Hacker to bring you incredible aha moments from the female iconic leaders in tech. Tara is no exception to that. So welcome and thanks for doing this.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm really excited to dig into this.
Yay, awesome. Well, before we dive into your aha moment, talk to us a little bit about your journey. It started long before Sprout, but you spent a good amount of time there, a lot of growth there. Now you're the chief marketing officer at Teamwork. Tell us a little bit about you.
Yeah, so I've been at Teamwork for about 4 months, first time CMO. So it's been a really fun journey kind of getting here. I would say early in my career, I jumped right into working at an agency where we were a small agency shop and grew really quickly. And so I started to lead, you know, at the very young age of right out of grad school, and grew that agency to, you know, over 300 people worldwide and building out a lot of our different systems, our creative division and digital marketing. And it gave me that quick lead into joining the SaaS world. And so went from the agency world into being the first marketer and heading up as a VP of marketing at Hotjar, which is a, you know, quick growing startup SaaS business. Then, as you just mentioned, moved over to Sprout Social, led marketing strategy there for a while, and more recently headed up customer marketing before joining Teamwork. So it's been a fun journey in both the agency space and then entering into the SaaS world and really growing across the board.
Very cool journey of growth and specialization and doing what you do really, really well. And I can imagine you've had a lot of moments of learning. So what's one of those aha light bulb moments that kind of changed the way that you work or think?
Yeah, and I love this question so much. And we were joking right before coming on. It's so hard to nail it down to just one aha moment. But I will give you probably one that comes back to me and I think about often in, you know, in that early to mid stage in my career. I think my biggest aha moment was that you don't know what you don't know. And as a leader, it is just so hard to try to have all the answers. And I think when you're early in your career, you think that you have to. And I know myself, I'm no exception to that. I lived in a lot of imposter syndrome early on in taking in a leadership career and taking on so much and trying to figure out how to do all the things. And once I had that relief of, you know, I don't have all the answers, but it's likely that someone out there does, and learned the importance of networking and the importance of connecting and community, and learning that those things are areas that, you know, you can be so thankful for and to continue to learn and give back. That, you know, it's one thing to have your own education, and I'm always learning and always growing, but every week I am on the phone with at least two additional people that are either in my own network or people that I'm just meeting, either asking questions or giving back and helping continue to expand. And I'm just so thankful for the investment that I've made in my network, the investment in companies like even Sales Assembly, where I know a lot of the work that I've done with that team has been connecting me with other CMOs as I was a first-time CMO. And that's probably the biggest aha for me, is like, just stop pretending to have all the answers or that I needed to have all the answers, and recognizing it's okay to say, I don't know, but I'll figure it out. And then communicate that back and make sure that you continue to create that clarity and create that recognition of humility that is just so important in leadership and your career.
I mean, this is such a poignant point for everybody, but especially I think women, or those who identify as women, we're afraid that we lose every bit of credibility the moment we say, I don't know. And it makes us fearful to uncover what we don't know, and then we miss growth. And if you think about it, what I love that you pointed out is that the foundation to learning something new is first the acknowledgement that you have a gap. If you don't know that you have to learn something, then you will never learn it. You know, like, right. If we never understand, hey, I have to walk, then we never walk. So it is the first step. So it's such an interesting counterbalance that we're so afraid of not knowing, and yet we have to not know in order to learn.
Absolutely. So. And not that fear of falling down. Like, we have to fall down to get back up and to get to learn and to be okay with that. And that's just such an important part of leadership and just our own growth in general.
Yeah, absolutely. An important part of leadership. Do you feel like it's the role of the leader to help their teams identify what they don't know?
Oh, that is a great question. I am a huge proponent of servant leadership and working with your team to serve and empower. And so I want my team and to hopefully everybody that I work with to have that okay feeling towards one, not knowing, but then two, taking risks and not being afraid to fail. And when you do fail, you fail forward and that you learn from that. And a lot of that comes in that stage of, where do we need to solve and where do we need to grow? We never stop growing, regardless of where we are in our career. And that's the same for someone on your team versus someone that you're working alongside versus yourself. And so I think that's a great question because I do think in a lot of ways I want to help empower and serve and encourage my team to learn the things that they want to learn in their career that they are motivated by, that they can partner with other people on, and then to do the same. I'm learning from the people that I work every single day.
Well, that is a beautiful aha moment that I think you probably just like, what if I ask this question in a couple of years, people are going to go, I had this aha moment. I was listening to this video and Tara said something and it just dawned on me. So I appreciate you coming, talking about this, and just kind of sharing your real raw moment that made you better because it'll make others better now too. So I appreciate it.
No, I love that so much. Well, thank you. And hopefully that's been helpful too. I know it's been a game changer for me.
Absolutely. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and we will see you all later.
Yeah, thank you.